Good evening. It is one thing to object to how the Attorney General of the United States characterized the Mueller report, which President Trump seized on to declare himself exonerated in the Russia investigation. It's another thing entirely when the person doing the objecting is Robert Mueller himself. And it's also a breaking news hitting the night before Attorney General William Barr is scheduled to testify before the Senate Judiciary Committee. Now, remember, for weeks, all we had was that four-page summary from Barr, which seemed to clear the president entirely. At least that's the way it was portrayed. Well, tonight we're learning that the special counsel had serious concerns about that, serious enough to write his old friend, the attorney general. CNN's Pamela Brown has the late details. So explain what we've learned about this letter.
Well, we are learning tonight, Anderson, that special counsel Robert Mueller sent a secret letter to the attorney general in late March. This was in the wake of that four-page letter that the attorney general had sent to Congress about the special counsel's investigation. And as you pointed out, Bill Barr, the attorney general, provided the principal conclusion, saying that the special counsel did not find collusion and that it couldn't reach a conclusion on obstruction of justice, and then went on to say that there wasn't sufficient evidence to show obstruction of justice. That conclusion reached by Barr. Well, now we're learning Mueller sent this letter to the attorney general expressing dissatisfaction that that four-page letter from Bill Barr did not accurately capture the nuance in the more than 400-page Mueller report that we have now seen in the redacted version. Robert Mueller, according to the Washington Post, saying in this letter to the attorney general, who was his boss, of course, is his boss and a longtime friend, saying that the redaction process of the Mueller report, quote, need not delay release of the enclosed materials. Release at this time would alleviate the misunderstandings that have arisen and would answer congressional and public questions about the nature and outcome of our investigations. So the principal concern was that Bill Barr's four-page letter to Congress shaped public perception, public understanding of the special counsel's investigation, when in fact, as we know, the picture that was laid out in the Mueller report was far more damning to the president, particularly on obstruction, than what Bill Barr conveyed. Even on the aspect of collusion, Anderson, as you'll recall, Bill Barr, as I pointed out, said there was no finding of collusion. But in Mueller's report, it went on to say the campaign expected help from Russia. And what is interesting is when Bill Barr previously testified to Congress, he said he included as much of Robert Mueller's report as he could. Well, that was clearly not the case as you look through the report. We're also learning that there were misgivings on the other side in the Justice Department about how Robert Mueller dealt with obstruction of justice, that officials, according to my colleague Laura Jarrett, were puzzled that Robert Mueller and his team never reached a conclusion on obstruction of justice. So clearly there were misgivings on both sides. But this is the first time we're learning, Anderson, of Robert Mueller himself sending this letter expressing his displeasure about how Bill Barr has handled the findings of his investigation. And this is sure to only give ammunition to those who have been skeptical and critical of Bill Barr's handling. He's going to be appearing before Congress tomorrow in a hearing.
Well, I mean, what's so fascinating about it is essentially Mueller is saying to Barr that he and his team wrote summaries that were ready for publication, wrote summaries that did not need to be redacted, that they had thought those out, that redactions would have no impact on the actual summaries that they had wrote, that those could be released and would give a fuller sense of what was actually in the report.
That's right. So that was conveyed. And Bill Barr's point of view, according to what we have learned, is that he didn't want to just release information in piecemeal fashion. His perspective was he wanted to release the full report with the redactions. Now, we've also learned from a Justice Department official that Robert Mueller did not tell Barr that anything he put in the letter was inaccurate. But the concern was more it didn't provide a fuller picture, didn't provide the nuance, and didn't provide the summaries that, as you pointed out, Robert Mueller's team wrote for public consumption, for Congress's consumption. And that was what Robert Mueller was trying to convey in this letter to Barr in late March, that he could release these summaries to clear up the misunderstanding about the findings while the redaction process was ongoing, Anderson.
Has the White House had any reaction to this? Because this is a story that just broke in the Washington Post just a short time ago.
The White House has not had a reaction. I've reached out to the White House, and they say they likely will not comment at that time. At this time, that doesn't mean that the president himself won't be tweeting. We do know, though, that before the Mueller report was released, Anderson, that there were communications between the White House Counsel's Office and the Department of Justice. And during the time of these communications, Bill Barr would have already received that letter from Mueller. And so it remains to be seen whether this was ever conveyed to the White House as well, Robert Mueller's displeasure.
All right, Pam Brown, thank you very much. Joining us now, CNN Chief Legal Analyst Jeffrey Toobin, CNN Senior Political Analyst David Gregory, also New York Times White House Correspondent, CNN Political Analyst Maggie Haberman, and Elliot Williams, who served as Deputy Assistant Attorney General under President Obama. Jeff, I mean, the Mueller letter, it certainly indicates and echoes what you and others have been saying before the full report was released, that Barr was clearly trying to shape the narrative, and it very obviously had alternatives and ignored them.
And distorted the meaning of the report. I mean, I just don't think there is any doubt now that we have read the vast majority of it, that Mueller was right, that Barr put out a misleading summary designed to spin it in a much more pro-Trump direction, shaped the public perception of the Mueller report forever, because 4 weeks there was no alternative view out there. And what we didn't know until today is that Mueller was pissed. Mueller was, you know, saw what was going on here and was powerless to do anything about it.
And Maggie, I mean, it's obvious the Attorney General of the United States was trying to make things look better for the President of the United States.
It's hard to come to any conclusion other than that he was putting the best possible face on this for the president. The argument from people who support Bill Barr has been, well, he was frustrated that Mueller did not come to a conclusion on the issue of obstruction, and he then had to handle this himself. You know, the argument that Mueller makes is that the letter, and the people on Mueller's team had made previously, is that the letter from Barr cherry-picked from the report, and it basically, you know, plucked certain clauses out here, certain sentences there, all of which painted this medley of Donald Trump being, you know, more or less exonerated, even though the letter acknowledged that there was a sentence in the report saying it didn't exonerate him. Mueller seems to have learned the lesson that a lot of people who have been around Donald Trump's world learned, and Mueller knows because they were almost all witnesses for him, that you have to put everything down on paper. This was not enough to just voice his concerns privately to Barr. There had to be a letter documenting it, and it's a stunning letter.
David Gregory, if Mueller was upset by the four-page summary, one can only imagine how he felt about William Barr the day the report was released, hours before it's released, the way he characterized it even then.
Right. I think there's no question that Bob Mueller was upset about that, the fact that Barr took it upon himself to, I think, execute on what was the original strategy of the White House, which is to get this report and pounce on it to create the narrative of what the response would be, what the reality of it would be, such that they have their own counter argument, their rebuttal that they never released, because they had Bill Barr to do that work for them. He did, in that four-page letter, say what I think was a crucial sentence, which is the president was not exonerated on the question of obstruction of justice, but lacking the context that I think was so much more powerful when we were all reading the report the day that it was released, is what Mueller was upset about. Now, here's the problem for Barr, is that Mueller is probably much more likely to testify now on the Hill, and they haven't been able to secure a date. I bet they secure one now. And I talked to somebody who was a friend of Mueller, walking over here, actually, who suggested, you know, what they ought to do is call him first. Let him now, on Capitol Hill, Mueller, set the tone for how he characterizes his own report and what comes next.
Elliot, if the reporting is correct, and Justice Department officials were taken aback by the tone of Mueller's letter, and it came as a surprise to them that he had such concerns, how could everyone not be on the same page?
Well, yeah, how could everyone not be on the same page? The interesting thing is that Mueller frames his concerns as, you know, looking out for public interest. He's looking out for the sort of how the Justice Department comes out of this. And I think a lot of the guests who've been on before have already talked about how Barr seemed to be protecting the President of the United States and not the interests of the Justice Department more generally. You know, this whole exercise was a fool's errand to begin with, to try to summarize a 440-some page document into a sort of a Cliff Notes version. Like, so for instance, as Jeffrey Toobin knows very, very well, when the Supreme Court issues opinions and issues summaries of them, they will issue paragraphs upon paragraphs of summary, taken directly from the text. You just can't do it without getting into trouble. And we saw that William Barr did. So it's not just a function of inaccurately doing it. It's also he went into it with a bias and an attempt to try to benefit the president of the United States, and it completely backfired. And so, you know, today we can thank Robert Mueller for looking out for the interests of the general public and the Justice Department, because it seemed that the leadership of the Justice Department wasn't quite there.
Yeah. Jeff, what does this say, I mean, about the Attorney General?
Well, you know, the reason this is such a big deal is that William Barr will never do anything as Attorney General remotely as important as that four-page letter. That was the defining moment of his service as Attorney General and the defining moment of the Mueller report for millions of people. And he misled the public.
Isn't that why he was hired? I mean, his audition?
It depends how cynical you are. I mean, that's not what he's supposed to do as Attorney General. I mean, he's supposed to be an honest broker. He's supposed to be someone who is not the president's lawyer, who is not Roy Cohn, who is someone responsible for the entire Department of Justice and U.S. government. And he misled the public at this critical, critical moment and shaped the perception of this report forever in a way to benefit the president.